together to have a glimpse of some of the typical Venetian houses. So here on the right hand side, this house is a pretty new Giudecca Canal, and we also have a huge building coming to our view on the right hand side ahead of us. Now this building used to be a ruin, you know, for about 800 years. They didn't know exactly what to do with it. It was the old wheat flour mill, and nowadays it has been restored and it is now a Hilton hotel. It's one of the hotels that we also use with Globus. We started using it this year, but they're not used to groups, and of course it's a kind of very fancy location. Now this building belonged to a wealthy American gentleman, Stuckey. In fact, if you have sharp eyes, in a few seconds as we go on the right hand side, you will see his surname is still written. We cannot see it yet. In a few moments we'll see it on the right hand side above the white umbrella, the Stuckey. It was called Molino Stuckey. So it was basically old pasta factory. Old pasta factory. We can see the sign just below the clock, Stuckey. Nowadays Hilton Hotel. As we're getting closer, we also see that beautiful church, and also here on the right-hand side, you see a dome, round dome. We no longer have this sharp shape going up to the sky when we go around the park. Here we have round cupolas, and the front facade decorated by white Italian marble. We have this triangle and the columns. So this architecture, very typical for Venice. This style of architecture is called Palladio. It's named after the architect Palladio. Now on the left-hand side, we're approaching the area that used to be the harbor of Venice in the past, because we had different kinds of boats in the past. Big ships that we have nowadays, they could not enter this area. It's not deep enough. So that church there that is being restored, maybe you remember I told you that for one of the Venetian churches, they needed 1,300,000 wooden pilings. That is the one, the church of Santa Maria. Islands and the Venetian Lagoon. Now, what about the peach color building, pinkish building next door, still on the left hand side? This is the Doge's Palace, and behind it we can see the domes of the Basilica of St. Mark. That basilica is 1,000 years old. So when we get off our boat, you know, we will walk. It takes about 20 minutes to walk along the water, passing St. Mark Square. I will stop at St. Mark Square just to point the Campanile Tower one more time, the tower that we are looking at here on the left-hand side, and then we go straight to the glass-blowing place. Afterwards, we're going to have our free time. So at Campanile there, 4:30, we'll be meeting for our gondolas. So St. Mark Square, this is the entrance. This view here on the left-hand side was described by Napoleon as the most beautiful entry of the world. On the left-hand side, we can see the Bridge of Sighs. I see connecting to Broadway. There is a tiny little white bridge, the second one, not the first one. The second one, this is where Casanova, the famous lover of Venice, he escaped from the prison, hidden below the skirt of the judge's wife.